My name's Simon Maidment. I'm the Curator of Contemporary Art at the National Gallery of Victoria in Melbourne, Australia. I have a particular interest in the Kochi-Muziris Biennale. I came to the initial iteration 2 years ago, and I've had the opportunity to visit twice now. I very much enjoyed this visit in particular. Kochi-Muziris is a very welcoming part of India, an incredible place in terms of its local history, its situation by the water, the architecture, which is unique to the south of India with its more Portuguese influence. So it's a ripe canvas for artists to be working in, either presenting their work in a new environment or creating works that come out of this specific context. This iteration, I've really found a strong connection between the works that do echo some of Jatish's own concerns in his art practice around connectivity, about the forces of nature at work on us as individuals and within society, naturally occurring rhythms, constellation, both the stars, but also the ways in which relations intersect and influence one another. So it's been a really rich offering here. Some of the aspects of the exhibition that really stand out were some of the really ambitious projects by Indian artists. I responded really strongly to Sahej Rahal's installation at the old lab here, an old chemistry lab and a science lab. And he's taken over the whole space with structures, constructs, sculptures made from unfired clay, some very small and some of gargantuan scale that kind of echo some kind of alien manifestation, semi-mechanical, semi-organic, and right down to the very minuscule and microscopic, almost dust-like. And it's a way to kind of also project not only just thinking about Kochi's history, but also, you know, a tongue-in-cheek and propositional way of engaging with the universe as a whole. Mitu Sen is another artist whose presentation at Kochi I found incredibly mesmeric. She has situated herself in a children's home and herself come as a sort of the persona of a wandering homeless person who speaks a language unto herself that shares common words or intonations with other languages but isn't readily understood. And the children take her into their care and look after this unwieldy persona who cannot really interact with the social norms of this world but is very present in her interactions with them. So I was very moved by that work of Mitu's, and it's an incredibly ambitious project. And I think in some ways that has been the hallmark of Jatish's Biennale, as opposed to the previous one, whereby many of the works aren't necessarily in terms of production values or scale ambitious, but conceptually or ambitious via the undertakings of the artists. There's also a number of aspects of the project that one anticipates seeing in a contemporary art exhibition that has a lot of Indian artists in it. Notions of boundaries and territory comes up quite a lot. But in this exhibition, there's also ideas of liminal space. So an artist like Adrian Paki, for instance, has done this fantastic video work whereby a large piece of granite marble is turned into a column with stonesmiths working on it while on the boat across the seas from China to Europe. So this kind of situation, turning the boat into a studio, was very powerful for me. And someone like Christian Waldvogel, who's also working with these notions of liminal space, I think is particularly interesting. He flew a very fast fighter jet above the Earth, mimicking the Earth's rotational speed. So he's literally sitting in one place, unmoving above a part of the geography below him. Those ideas of a different kind of relationship to the earth and to country and to a situation is one that I found particularly arresting and interesting. And then there's a number of artists whose work very much spoke to me about notions of the poetic action of an artist in those landscapes. Someone like Neha Choksi, for instance, who has rowed a boat out into the middle of a lake that is made entirely of ice. And as she rows, this attempt to make from one landfall to another And is thwarted by the melting of this boat. And similarly, an artist like Guido van der Verve. Guido has a marvelous video of himself walking in front of an icebreaker on the ice, sort of oblivious to this machine behind him. All of these artists really speak to different ways we can understand country, borders, and connectedness. And one of the most powerful of those is the opening work by Mona Hatoum, which is a work whereby there is a circle of breathing light globes whose pulses go up and down with the slowness of breathing. And yet when their wires all come together, they're interwoven into what looks like kind of a matting or a tapestry. So these are all works that speak very poetically and in some cases politically to the situation that we find ourselves in, but in these soft and observational ways that I found particularly interesting in Jatisha's presentation. As many have noticed, there has been a rise of the international exhibition, particularly in the form of triennials and biennales around the world. Kochi-Muziris brings its rich history to that discussion, which is something that I think is particularly unique. And very much it is a biennale that is important to that network of other biennales and an international art network, but more specifically important to India. And it is really the only event of its type in this region, in India, and speaking to the histories, the unique histories and the unique physical composition of many of the places where those histories are played out. So it brings with it the rich tapestry that artists can then exploit in their work, in new practice, or as a complex web before which one can present an artwork that may be pre-existing and look at in a different way. And I don't think all biennales around the world can offer that. Something else that I think is particularly appealing and of interest to me in the model of the Kochi-Muziris Biennale is that it's often done this with very few funds and with something that has acting as a platform to engender and to leverage the goodwill of an ever-tightening community of artists both in India and people connected with the art scene in India. And I think this is incredibly important. It brings with it the same kind of gravitas and the same kind of opportunity. But as I said, it acts as this kind of motor for connectedness and generosity, but one critically engaged with its histories and its futures, I think, in India, and really does offer a platform for some of the most interesting contemporary art coming out of this region.